Why didn't Kyle Shanahan play Josh Rosen at all during the final two games of the season? Those were the Beathard games. And I ask because Beathard's an unrestricted free agent. I think we all expect he's gone. So what was the point of the Beathard games, and why didn't Rosen get like a snap?
I have two theories on it, or two parts. One, I think because at the time we didn't know what Nick Mullins' injury was, so it could have been if they wanted a backup quarterback that knows the system, C.J. Beathard would be that guy, that third-string guy that knows the system and can help guys along, so who knows. But my other theory is what the Saints did with Jameis Winston this year is they didn't play him, and they kept him cheap, and they're probably going to be able to re-sign him this year. And now Josh Rosen, no one really cares about him. As you're saying, no one pays attention to Josh Rosen, and the Niners are going to get him back for dirt cheap and have him for preseason, and he gets to work a whole offseason without either being exposed without knowing the system or being exposed to other teams that would want to bring him in for their quarterback situation.
The reason why I feel like Rosen didn't play each of the last two games is he was signed, I want to say, right before that Cardinals game, the second to last game of the season. And we all know how loyal Kyle Shanahan is to his guys. Beathard was his quarterback that he selected in the third round back in 2017. And when Beathard stepped onto the field, look at what happened each of the last two games. It was a feel-good moment for Beathard. As to whether or not that's actually why Rosen didn't step on the field, who knows? But he led, he being Beathard, beat the Cardinals, and then he had the lead against the Seahawks for the majority of that game. So I'm assuming Shanahan just kept the hot hand on the field, the quarterback that's been really facilitating the offense well, and there wasn't really a need to bring in Rosen other than the fact that he's the new toy that came in, and we could see what he can do on the field for potential future use.
Yeah, Shanahan would probably say, well, he didn't know the offense. He'd only been here for a little bit. Forget that, man. The games didn't count. You were out of contention. You didn't have to win. You're trying to play people who have a future or see if they have a future. You're trying to learn about your roster. That's what you're trying to do. And instead, look, you played your friend, C.J. Beathard, your buddy. You really like C.J. And maybe you felt you owed it to him, or he'd been through a lot, or he's got a tough story, or yada, yada, yada. You played your friend who's an impending unrestricted free agent. Doesn't make any sense. And sure, maybe he was more prepared than Josh Rosen, played better in practice. I don't care. He's not going to be on this team next year. Josh Rosen will be. Change the offense. Dumb it down. Do what you did for Jimmy Garoppolo to get him on the field in 2017. You know, let him hand off. Call like seven passes. Give him a shot. Now, I don't know. I think basically you're right. He didn't do it because he wants to do a solid for his friend. I also feel like he's a little afraid, he feels burned by what happened with Jimmy. He put Jimmy on the field for five games. Jimmy took off, and now he was stuck with Jimmy for the rest of his life. And he's not going to let that happen again with Josh Rosen. No, but the other conspiracy could be, how about this? Wasn't ready. If you put him in those last two games, you set him up for failure. He has a bad game. No one wants him. Maybe you leave him on the bench, let him learn the offense, let him learn the players, give him an entire offseason, and then when he finally has a good preseason game or steps in because Jimmy Garoppolo gets hurt and actually plays well, now you got someone. Now you have a confident quarterback who's changed the narrative about him, and you've set him up for success. Could that be the conspiracy theory here, that Kyle's actually doing the right thing and actually values Josh Rosen? Or is this guy disposable to him?
Well, the one thing I think of is when quarterbacks come in without really knowing the system. Obviously, Jimmy Garoppolo had a couple of weeks when he was acquired midseason and had a great end to the season. But the two guys that are glaring in my mind are, do you remember when Carson Palmer went to the Raiders and they threw him in that Chiefs game? And I think his first pass was a pick six, and I think he had two picks in that game. Same with Josh Freeman when he went to Minnesota on that horrible Monday Night Football game, which is the worst game I've ever seen on TV. And I think he threw a pick and had like a 40 QB or QB rating. And I think that's an issue, is like loss of confidence. And he's already had a lot of issues of loss of confidence, I would assume, with all the teams giving up on him, that maybe you didn't want to rush him back and then totally lose the guy. Next year, he'll be in a much more favorable situation with a mini camp and preseason.
Yeah, that's cool with me. If we could have Kyle here and I'd ask him, why didn't you play Rosen? He said, well, look, I really like him. I'm trying to set him up for success. Let me get an offseason with him. That would make sense to me. But if his answer was because he sucks, I would say, no, CJ sucks. No. CJ sucks. And playing CJ when he was out the door sucked. So I just want to know where Kyle's coming from. He signed him. So maybe he does value the guy in some way. I just don't know. We'll find out soon enough. Easy Tino says, guys, I'm a retired U.S. Air Force and I know leadership. Coach Kyle is not a leader. He inspires nobody. Reminds me of a second and reminds me of second and first lieutenants trying to be commanders. I wasn't in the Air Force. I don't exactly know what second and first lieutenants are like. But I would have to agree with Easy that he just doesn't strike me as a classic leader. I think people follow him because they respect his intellect. They acknowledge that he's the best at what he does in terms of play design. But yeah, he's looking at his play sheet. And I think that's part of the reason why he brought in Saleh and replaced Saleh with Ryan's, because those two are natural alpha leaders. Mm-hmm. And I think that they're a good complement for Kyle. I think Kyle may even probably know that's his weakness, you know, if it is one, which I think it is. So, but that's okay. I mean, look, it's not really okay, but he does have these defensive coordinators who help and seem to fill in the gap, I believe. So mm-hmm. Can you lead from a coordinator position? I don't know. If your defense is better than the offense, maybe you can.